Some are no.
I want to see everybody looking, everybody listening.
So today we are going to be talking about text features, which I know this is going to be something that you have seen before, but it really, really helps us when we're reading informational text. These are things like a glossary in a book, a table of contents, in Scholastic News when you have the bolded words and words to know section. It's stuff like that that organizes text and makes it easier to understand and easier for us to find things. So I wanted to start out by showing off a vocabulary video that does a great job explaining different kinds of text features. Guide when you're reading to help you find things that you're looking for, or if you don't pictures with captions and bold words and different words that are highlighted. So it's not just the language arts. So the next thing we are going to do, we are going to take a look at the same article, but we're going to look at it without text features and with text features, and we're going to see how it's different and how text features can help us out when we're reading.
David Cross of Stony Brook University in New York made the discovery and is working together with other scientists to determine how Bezoar bufo is related to other frogs and to understand how and why they are on the island of Madagascar. Fossil frog experts Susan Evans and Mark Jones of University College of London agree that the new frog represents the first known
occurrence
of a fossil group in Madagascar with living relatives in South Africa.
Okay. This one. Shelby, will you read the next paragraph for us?
The eels and buffo.
The eels and buffo.
Appears to be a very close relative of a group of South African frogs known as
Ceratophrens,
or Pac-Man frogs, because of their immense mouths that said frogs. But why wasn't really buffo found in South Africa? We are asking
South America.
We are asking ourselves what's a South African frog? South American frog been halfway around the world in Madagascar itself. One possibility is that there was a land connection between South America and Madagascar during the late
Cretaceous
period. Some researchers believe that Antarctica, Madagascar, and South America may all have been connected at one point.
Thank you so much.
So a frog hopped all the way to Madagascar.
The largest frogs on the record.
2 pounds, 3.2 kilograms. The largest frog alive on Madagascar today is just over 4 inches, 10.1 centimeters long.
Thank you, Tana. Okay. So now we are going to read this same article with text features so we can see how they are different and how text features might improve something like this. Okay.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. Okay. So what is the first thing y'all notice that's different about this
article? It's got a big old picture.
It's
got a heading.
Title.
It has
a heading.
Title.
Yes.
It has bold words.
Subheading.
Bold words. Big old fat frog.
So it has all of those things. But the first thing that I noticed is it has a title. Because we know what we're reading about. The other one, it didn't even have a title. So we just went in not knowing anything. Now we know it's about Beelzebufo, a giant of a find. So if we can guess a lot from that.
And it's compared to the frogs we have today. You think you have a big frog out in your yard?
Yeah, but that picture is comparing it to like a frog.
And that thing is like this big. Dude, look. That thing is like this big.
And like someone said, we have subheadings. So we've got subheadings right here. So we can see what this section is going to be about. Like this says a surprising discovery. So we know that someone is going to be discovering something. Okay, so I'm going to call on two more people to read.
That is what's eating my neighbor's sausage.
Who's number two?
Wes.
Hey, Wes. Can you read the paragraph for us?
A team of researchers in Madagascar has discovered the fossil of what may be the largest frog to ever have lived. The beach ball-sized amphibian, which grew to be about the 40.6 centimeters long and weighed about 10 pounds, 4.5 kilograms. A scientist is scientifically named Beelzebufo or
Beelzebufo. It's a hard word. I had to look up how to say it.
Or
okie doke. Okay. So, who's number one? Okay, Patrick, will you read the next paragraph for us? And that sentence. You're going to read paragraph and that sentence. 7.
Trey.
Trey. Okay, Trey, will you read the paragraph for us?
Me, the hoopoe, is without a doubt one of the largest frogs on record and was perhaps the largest frog to ever exist. The size, appearance, and predatory nature of this frog prompted its discoverers to call it the armored frog from the darkest night. The name Bezalabufo comes from the Greek word for devil, Bezalabob, and the Latin word for toad,
thank you.
You said that really good.
Okay. Who's number 20? Hey, can you read these last two paragraphs for us?
Get the train line up.